Hi, my name is Osan Kwon at the University of Toronto. In this presentation, I'm going to introduce a high-level summary of a hybrid simulation method, the University of Toronto simulation framework, which we termed as UTSIM framework, and the network interface for controllers for the MTS 793 controller software. I'm going to present the slide in four sections. So introduction, UTSIM framework, NICON for MTS 793, and the summary. In various research fields and practices in structural engineering, we routinely run experiments because in many cases, we cannot numerically simulate the behavior of structural elements or systems subject to extreme loads, such as earthquake or fire. So we routinely run static cyclic tests or sometimes shaking table tests of a system or fire endurance tests of an element in a furnace. Even though the structural testing is one of the most realistic way to understand structural elements or systems behavior, there are limitations as well. The largest limitation is the scale of structural elements in buildings or bridges. As you know, in civil engineering, the buildings and bridges are very large scale. So we cannot build the system model and test them. It is very expensive and we don't have equipment to do that. We can run components tests, but even components are in very large scale in many cases. So component level tests are limited in scale as well. When you do component level tests, there are limitations in boundary conditions as well. When you run component level tests, we assume that that component is part of the system and somehow idealize the applied load and applied boundary conditions to the specimen. So this type of prescribed motion or prescribed displacement history does not consider bidirectional interaction with the rest of the structural system. So we can understand component behavior well, but it is hard to understand how this component will behave in a structural system or how the structural system will behave due to the behavior of the tested specimen. To overcome this limitation, the idea of hybrid simulation methods have been developed for several decades. In seismic engineering, Hakuno et al. Started developing hybrid simulation in 1969. And in fire engineering, Kwon et al. Has developed the hybrid simulation method in 1999. The main idea in hybrid simulation is the integration of a numerical model or numerical models with physical specimen. And then the simulation method tries to enforce equilibrium at each time step. So we can understand the interaction between the system level model and component level specimen. Let me give you an example. For a structure subject to dynamic load, such as earthquake load, we solve this equilibrium equation. In this equilibrium equation, the restoring force term is typically difficult to model numerically, especially for a structure subject to seismic load. So to represent the static behavior of structural element, the behavior of a structural element experimentally, you can build a specimen in the lab and build the rest of the system numerically and integrate them and then put them back into the equation of motion. So by solving this equilibrium equation step by step, we can simulate system level behavior where part of the system is modeled physically. For instance, this is a four-story building where each story has a brace, and at the end of the brace, there is a yielding connector. So this yielding connector acts as an energy dissipation mechanism. This yielding connector, which is made of cast steel, is difficult to model numerically. So the static behavior of this element is not typical behavior that we can see from structural elements. So for this kind of problem, we can model the system the components experimentally like this, and then integrate this components, physical components with the numerical model. And then run seismic simulation in the numerical model where the restoring forces of the components are fed back to the numerical model at each time step. So we can see the static behavior of the components that are used to understand the behavior of this system. And we can also understand that the boundary conditions imposed to the specimens are more realistic because it comes from the interaction with the numerical model of this system. For the case of structures subject to fire, we are still solving equilibrium equation, but we do not need to consider inertial force or damping force. In this kind of problem, understanding the restoring force is difficult because these structural element restoring force is a function of displacement as well as temperature load. So to solve this kind of problem more realistically, we can model the component in fire in a furnace and impose boundary condition while the rest can be modeled numerically. For example, we can build a model of a building in abacus and model the first story column in a furnace. And then you can run interactive simulation to understand how this column in a building system will behave when it is subject to fire load. So in short, hybrid simulation can be used to simulate complicated problems, which is difficult to model numerically. So we can represent some of the elements' behavior experimentally, while the rest of the system can be modeled numerically. To facilitate such hybrid simulation method, we develop a framework for hybrid simulation. We call it as University of Toronto Simulation Framework, which is termed as UT Sim Framework. In many problems, you won't use different software to model the structural system. Sometimes you want to use OpenSeas. Sometimes you want to use LS-DYNA, Abacus, or S-Frame, for example. Or you may also want to build your own system model in MATLAB, Python, C, or any other languages. So you're not proposing that any one of them needs to be used as a main program. When I say framework, we are proposing overall procedure and tools to facilitate the hybrid simulation. So in the UTSIM framework, we have developed a standard way of exchanging data between different analysis software, such that any one of these tools can be used as a main simulation program, and any one of these tools can be used to represent substructure element numerically. So I call it as R sub n, so numerical restoring force vector. Or you can represent part of the restoring force vector from experiment, which is R sub e. So in the UTSIM framework, we first develop a standardized data exchange format and communication protocol. So we first predefined the data exchange format and the communication protocol. And to facilitate implementation of this communication protocol, we also develop a library. So if any program calls this library and send the data packet through this library to other program, the programs can be integrated into a hybrid simulation. These libraries are accessible from C++, Fortran, LabVIEW, MATLAB, or Python. I think many other programming languages can access this kind of libraries. So what it means by then NICON? In the hybrid simulation, as I mentioned earlier, you have a numerical model of a system and the physical model of a component. You want to integrate this to the numerical model of the system. So to do that, the numerical model needs to predict boundary condition, displacement boundary condition, impose it to a controller which runs the experiment, and obtain measured response, typically measure the force vector and send it back to the numerical model. Typical controllers do not have such functionality. So initially we developed this program called NICON, Network Interface for Controllers, using analog I/O signal. So analog I/O signals are used to allow communication between the program called the NICON AIO with controller. And this NICON communicate with the numerical model through TCP/IP communication. We chose analog I/O for most of the controllers initially, including the MTS controller, because hydraulic actuator controls are typically equipped with analog I/O channels. Some of them are also equipped with a ScrapNet, Etherkit, or Modbus TCP, but analog I/O was quite universal. Recently, we have collaborated with MTS such that we can directly communicate with MTS 793 software through an interface program, NICON MTS 793. By allowing data communication directly between NICON MTS 793 to MTS 793, we can eliminate the analog I/O interface. By doing that, we can transfer data more accurately without worrying about the noise, and also configuration of the experiment is much simpler. So in NICON MTS 793, user-defined Python script can be used for in-house development of processing of data, such as error compensation schemes, and MTS CSIC software is used to map channels and to define control modes. The next demonstration, you will see an example of running hybrid simulation where a system is built as a frame, a three-dimensional one-story, one-bay frame, and one of the column is represented experimentally. We'll use NICON MTS 793 to facilitate communications between the numerical model and the specimen, and various analysis software will be used, such as OpenSys or Abacus, for this hybrid simulation. So through the development, any researchers and engineers can use any of these programs to represent the system level model, and any specimens that are tested with the MTS 793 software can be integrated in the hybrid simulation. If needed, part of the system can be modeled more in detail using Abacus, Vector, or OpenSys as well. In short, we have developed UTSIM framework to facilitate multi-platform hybrid simulations. We have developed interface modules for several commercial software such as Abacus, LS Dyna, S-Frame, Cyrus, Vector, and UI Synco, and OpenSys. And custom software written in MATLAB, Python, LabVIEW, or Fortran, and C languages can be easily integrated in the hybrid simulation. We have developed NICON with analog I/O interface for generic or general hydraulic controllers. And most recently, we have collaborated with MTS to integrate NICON MTS 793 into the hybrid simulation. All the examples and manuals for this hybrid simulation will be available at the UTSIM website, given in this link below. Thank you.